Looking at some of the footage, it must have been incredible for you guys. How was it connecting with all your fans from across the country and other continents all over the place? You're still dying of laughter about the hair.
Yeah.
Why? Am I being deceived? Is that why you're laughing? Did I call it out?
No. I just loved that moment. Sorry.
It was a good moment.
Oh, we're back. Sorry.
No, I mean, being able to, like, connect.
You try to pull it back. You try to
rein it in, Quanko.
We just hit loopy.
Okay.
So really go.
Your hair looks good, by the way.
It was nice to see us being able to deal.
Yeah, so what was it like for you guys being able to connect?
No, but seriously, it was like, you know, being able to give back to those fans and being able to show. No, you can't laugh now. This is no. This is no.
Corey's like my saving grace here. He just keeps trying to reel it back. I want to say I appreciate you. It must have been good though.
Well, could you imagine yeah. going into a room of, you know, 20,000 people, of people who don't usually get to see you in person. They usually watch you on television. They usually, you know, they're following you on the internet, doing all these things. And they get to see you in person.
Rewarding though, because having watched the movie, like, it's kind of rewarding at the end. You feel like I had no idea what to expect. You're laughing at the heartwarming stories right now. Is that what you're laughing at?
No.
The giggles. This happens.
I'll answer your question.
When you get the giggles on set.
No, I just want to say, you know, how rewarding, because there's a lot, you know, the show tackles a lot of social issues, obviously.
Yeah.
You know, that's one of the things that I think people gravitate to. And then the movie's cut up with these interstitials of heartwarming stories. So I wonder if you guys being on the road, like, how many fans did you meet that share those kind of stories, and how rewarding it for you guys to meet people like that, that not only inspire, but in addition, you give them, like, almost like a place in society. Mm-hmm.
We got to meet a lot of people that, you know, had stories similar to that. During meet and greets and mm-hmm. stuff, like, we did a bunch of meet and greets, and we would get letters and then read them in the car, and, you know, it's person after person and story after story. And it's overwhelming, and it keeps us humble mm-hmm. and lets us know that we are part of something that's just bigger than just a television show. Mm-hmm. And to know that you're doing this for, you know, you're not just entertaining people, you're also changing their lives is, like, you know, it's something that we never thought that we would be doing, but we are, and so we're very grateful for it.
Now for you, you know, this upcoming season, you're a senior, you know, thoughts, how you feeling? What's the sentiment like on set, considering you might not be coming back? You might not be coming back next year.
I mean,
year.
It's bitter. Feeling? It's bittersweet. You know, it's been such a lovely time being on the show, mm-hmm. Unequivocally. And it's like I'll stay as long as they'll have me. You know, mm-hmm. But at the same time, you know, can't be the 35-year-old senior. You know.
What about your band? Is that something you think about? Yeah, but doing, I mean.
Have you seen him on the drums?
No, I haven't. I haven't. It's I've nuts. Seen a little bit. Yeah,
yeah, sticks. Sweet. Yeah. And what's funny is, I think because you've been practicing so much because of the show and outside of the show, whereas he started off excellent, he has now surpassed excellence.
Wow.
He is. Remember that song? There was this episode. I forget the song. Leah's singing the song. It's a Fleetwood Mac song, and you're playing the drums.
Going your own way.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And it's an incredibly hard drum.
Yeah, it is.
Are you bragging for him right now?
This is
bragging for me. You're bragging for him.
Yeah, but it's true. He's good.
Yeah, it's a warm moment.
No, the band is good. We just played a show in Pennsylvania mm-hmm. a few days ago. So that was fun.
Are all your bandmates super geeked because they know that now you guys have this fan base now who will hopefully follow the band and carry on?
Yeah, they do. Like, a huge part of our fan base is from Glee, obviously. And people really seem to like the music, and we're going to be recording some stuff soon, putting a couple videos, a couple songs out soon that people haven't heard before.
So. Naya, too.
Looking forward to it. Thank you very much. Nice meeting you guys.
So I have seen maybe two episodes of Glee. This is obviously, you know, an extension of the television show, but this is Glee in 3D, the concert movie. You guys blew me away. I was not aware, for whatever reason, of the amazing talent and amazing voices.
Well, it's a blessing. I mean, you know, being on the show and being a part of the cast and getting to do what we do every day and do things like perform for thousands of people at, you know, the O2, the Staples Center. Like, these are things that are blowing my mind that I never thought that I would be doing, and I'm sure everybody feels that way.
Selling out the Staples Center twice in a day is
not bad.
Yeah. Do you ever think that you'd be, like, in this place, especially coming from a television show and then, like, being able to have the opportunity to perform, being able to sing and to be in concert?
No, and especially because for a while, anything that attempted a musical anything wasn't really accepted. And
I grew up loving musicals, but I had a mom that raised me with that awareness, and I would try to get my friends to watch them when they came over, and they didn't like that idea so much, especially when they were in black and white. But, you know, it hit at the right time, and it had the right messages, and we've been really lucky, and I don't think you ever think too far ahead, because you don't want disappointment. Not to say that you don't hope for the best, but this has definitely surpassed, I think, what we all thought the best case scenario might have been.
One of the things you just hit on was this feeling that I had as I'm watching you guys perform, which I've gotten from musicals in the past, which is, I don't want this to end. I know it has to come to an end, but I don't want this to end. Did you guys kind of have that feeling as well while you're performing?
It's such an enthralling, amazing experience being up on that stage. And it's so different from what we do on the television show.
And then I would stay up till 4:30 in the morning, being like, I can't sleep.
Yeah, because you're so wired.
Because you finish the concert and you're home by like 12, and you're wide awake.
Yeah.
Because of all of that that's going on around you.
I can see that.
So I became an insomniac, which was kind of fun as well.
Naya, you have this amazing, you get to sing Valerie. Mm-hmm. You want to talk to me about your performance?
Oh my gosh, dream come true. Like, I found out that, and like, these are my favorite songs that I would, if I could suggest, I would have suggested that song, and it just so happened to be in the script. Yeah. And I was freaking out, obviously, because I'm a huge Amy Winehouse fan, and obviously devastated by her loss, but... you know, I loved the song, and it's so cool now because it's a whole new thing, you know, it's kind of like a tribute, and who knew, and I don't know, everything kind of just fit together, and I think that's something that's so cool. It'll be like, you know, etched in time forever that I got to sing that song.
And the performance is so high octane. Do you want to talk to me a little bit about the
dancing? Yeah, the dancing, Heather and Harry, like, killed it. They were amazing. Like flipping over each other.
And, no, like, I was like, I want to do that.
Like crab walking. I would try not to like look at what was going on because I would just stop singing and stare.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's a great performance. I loved it. I thought we did a great job.
This movie could not have been made without you guys as fans. There's so much to the fans, and that element is just absolutely crucial. You guys want to talk to me a bit about your fans?
I mean,
dear hearts.
Yeah, I mean, they're so supportive, and they're always there, you know, and I think they really got as much out of it as we did, I think, on this concert experience, because I feel like we got so much out of it as well. Mm-hmm. Just giving that, showing up, doing it with them. I felt collaborative almost.
Yeah.
You guys have this diva thing going here. Who's the biggest diva?
Who's the biggest diva?
Yes. Did we have an answer?
Cory.
We hit a nerve.
Can't you see this guy, never smiling?
Yeah. He's just is this over yet?
Always pissed
I don't
off.
Have time for this. Yeah.
Those dimples just reeking with tension and anger.
Unbearable.
Aggression. Suck.
I think I might know.
This is life rage.
We're done here.
You know? I think we might.
I think we're rager. Done. I think we're done.
Yeah.
I guess the final question, the t-shirts. If you guys could have anything on your t-shirt, what would it be?
I'm a dork.
I was going to say nerd.
I'd probably say dork. Loud.
Loud.
I know I have to graduate at some point, but, you know, I'm around for season 3.
I know that I'm a senior, so... whatever happens this year, I guess, you know, like you've been to high school, what happens when you're a senior and you graduate?
That's the hardest thing with any show is knowing where it lasts and where it rests, and time will tell.